A defiant Volodymyr Zelensky receiving multiple standing ovations from the British House of Commons.
We will not give up, and we will not lose. We will fight in the forests, in the fields, on the shores, on the streets.
Zelensky likely reminding his audience of the wartime inspirations of Winston Churchill, who addressed the same body after the evacuation of Dunkirk.
We shall fight in the fields and in the streets. We shall fight in the hills. We shall never surrender.
Of course, he's definitely trying to channel Winston Churchill. I mean, one thing that's very important to remember about Zelensky is he is a performer.
Zelensky's use of social media and other platforms has allowed him to dominate the information war. From his interview with CNN's Matthew Chance from his bunker.
First of all, everybody has to stop fighting.
To a defiant address from behind his desk on Monday, the first time he was seen there since the invasion began.
I'm staying in Kyiv, in my office. I'm not hiding, and I'm not afraid of anyone.
To a video posted on Facebook from the streets of Kyiv with his cabinet on the second night of the invasion, delivering a similar message.
The president is here. We are all here. Our military are here.
Analysts say there's no doubt Zelensky's almost daily messages have stiffened the backbone of the Ukrainian military and its citizens, and have even resonated inside his enemy's borders.
Some of his recent video messages, it must be said, have been quite powerful, including the message to the Russian people that he gave, where he basically called on them to resist this war, which was quite emotional.
The images of Zelensky meeting with his troops as they prepared for battle, of selfie videos posted from the streets.
This is our land, our country, and we are defending all of it.
These are products, analysts say, of a leadership team which knows how to connect with younger audiences.
They're very in tune with that younger generation. These guys really master social media in a way that has been very effective.
Contrast that with the autocrat in the Kremlin, who sits distanced from aides at long tables and whose messages to his country seem increasingly disconnected.
He appears fearful. You just get the sense of a man alone. Whereas Zelensky is among his people, among his team, and in the fight.
All of which means that if Zelensky is killed, imprisoned, or driven out, the loss of those messages would be devastating for Ukrainians. Analysts point out there are other Ukrainian leaders who could take up the slack, like former President Petro Poroshenko or Kyiv Mayor Vitaly Klitschko, who have been bravely transmitting messages from the streets. But it's unlikely they would have the residence of Volodymyr Zelensky. Brian Todd, CNN, Washington.
It was really an amazing moment, right? This was President Zelensky speaking to the British House of Commons yesterday, and he seemed to conjure, evoke Winston Churchill. Let's listen.
We will not give up, and we will not lose. We will fight till the end, at sea, in the air. We will continue fighting for our land, whatever the cost. We will fight in the forests, in the fields, on the shores, in the streets.
That is no accident.
No, not at all. That is an intentional direct echo of Churchill's famous speech from June 4th, 1940. We will fight them on the beaches. We shall never surrender. And that's why it was greeted with a standing ovation in British Parliament. Zelensky's speeches have been able to inspire and change policy when it comes to speaking to people in the West. And one of the big questions at the outset of this, I think, for a lot of folks was, is Zelensky a former comedian, actor? Is he going to be Ashraf Ghani, or is he going to be Winston Churchill? We now know the answer. He's going to be Winston Churchill.
Yeah.
And he's drawn the people together in a way that he stiffened their spine. Now, I know that a lot of foreign diplomats would like him to leave, but they now understand he's not leaving Kyiv. And if he is assassinated by the Russians in the process, he becomes a martyr, and that continues to draw the Ukrainian people together. As one diplomat told me, he becomes the most famous Ukrainian of all time.
He's almost single-handedly, I think, especially because he's evoking so much World War II through so much of what he's saying, John. He's almost single-handedly making people, Western allies, wonder, oh my God, is this the sort of the beginning of a World War III? And if it is, and whatever comes after this, what are we going to do right now? Right? It's sort of a reckoning that he's creating.
Well, look, I mean, I think one of the things that this invasion has made us realize is that many of us took the peace created after the Second World War for granted. The liberal international order that was established by America and its allies, and it is a rules-based society. That's what Vladimir Putin is directly attacking, as well as the people of Ukraine. And we are confronting that every day. It has caused us to double down on our defense of these alliances, that NATO and the Western world is more united now because we're not taking this for granted because of Vladimir Putin's aggression. And Zelensky is in a position to highlight that. So, yes, I think we realize now why these institutions were created, why they need to be defended, why we need to defend the liberal democratic order because of things like this. Because the alternative is people who believe that might makes right, people who believe they can lie to their people and rule by force and murder to get their way. And we cannot allow that to be the trajectory of the 21st century.
Yeah, I think there was also this thought in World War II, oh, they'll just stop at Poland, right?
Yeah.
And
yeah.
People wonder,
guess what?
Oh, will he really just stop it at Ukraine? You know, like
just
what comes
Sudan
after
land.
This?
Yeah.
Kim, John, thank you so much for the discussion. Really appreciate it.